In the name of Allah, who is the most beneficent and the most merciful. Assalamu alaikum to all of you. Today our topic is benzene. First of all, we will study what is how benzene was discovered. Benzene was discovered by Michael Faraday in 1825 in the gas produced by destructive distillation of vegetable oil. Now, what is destructive distillation? Destructive distillation is heating any material at high temperature and high pressure. So then after Michael Faraday discovery, 20 years later, Hoffman also discovered it in by coal tar. It's after discovery, then we came towards its structure. For its structure, its empirical formula was calculated by elemental analysis. Second thing is that its molecular mass is determined by vapor density method. And it was found out to be 78.108. And this 78.108 was 6 times the empirical formula mass of CH. CH means CH, carbon is 12, hydrogen is 1, and 12 plus 1 is equal to 13, and its molecular mass that was calculated was 78.108. It means this, it's 6 times result in 78.108. So molecular formula of benzene was C6H6, and this molecular formula indicate that it is highly unsaturated compound. So then after this structure, we came towards the X-ray structure of benzene. X-ray structure of benzene gave us the following information. First of all, it tells us that benzene is hexagonal, means it has 6 sides. Second thing is that all the carbon and hydrogen are in the same plane. Third one is all the bond angles are of 120 degree. Next is CC bond length is 1.397 Armstrong, and all the CH bond lengths are 1.09 Armstrong. Okay, so it was according to the X-ray study. This shows that benzene are hexagonal, and all the carbon hydrogen are in the same plane, all the bond lengths bond angles are of 120 degree, carbon bond lengths are 1.397 Armstrong, and carbon hydrogen bond lengths are 1.09 Armstrong. Okay, after X-ray study, then atomic orbital treatment or modern structure of benzene was calculated. So atomic orbital treatment of benzene was hexagonal structure of benzene was confirmed by hybridization, or we can say that its hexagonal structure was conveniently explained by hybridization. And according to this point of view, each carbon atom in benzene is sp2 hybridized. These three sp2 hybrid orbitals, they are involved in making 3 sigma bonds. These are the 3 sigma bonds, 2 with adjacent carbon atoms and 1 with hydrogen. And it was also found out that all the carbon and hydrogen atoms are coplanar, means they are in the same plane. Next one is unhybridized pz orbital. Pz orbital remain at right angle. Remain at right angle to these sp2 hybrid orbitals, because here sp2 means the two p orbitals are involved in hybridization. The third one is pz, which remains unhybridized, and this unhybridized orbital remains at right angle to sp2 hybrid orbitals. In this way, if we draw its in this way, all these are pz orbitals that remains unhybridized, and these pz orbitals overlap with each other and to form a continuous sheet of electronic cloud above and below the carbon-carbon sigma bonds. These pz unhybridized orbitals overlap and form this continuous sheet. This is continuous sheet of electronic cloud that envelop above and below the cc sigma bonds. As this pz orbital is overlapped with this pz orbital, means both are pz orbitals, the result in a diffused or delocalized electrons. Delocalized electrons result, or electronic cloud, we can say that. Electronic cloud result. So this was atomic orbital treatment, and you can understand it according to this, that each carbon is sp2 hybridized. All the these are sp2 hybridized, means the three sp2 orbitals form two sigma bonds with the adjacent carbon atom and one with the adjacent hydrogen atom, and all these carbon and hydrogen atoms are in the same plane. That's why they are called as coplanar. And the third one, p orbital, which is pz orbital, remains unhybridized, and this unhybridized remains at right angle, and after that it is overlaps with each other and form continuous sheet of electronic cloud enveloping above and below the carbon-carbon sigma bond, and this results in this delocalization throughout the ring, and due to this delocalization has great effects on benzene structure. Next one is we will consider its stability, how it is stable. So we can determine its stability by comparing it with hypothetical molecule is 1,3,5 cyclohexatriene. By determining its heat of hydrogenation, first of all consider cyclohexene. Its structure is this one, means it has one double bond. When it is hydrogenated, then it forms cyclohexane, and then del H value is determined, which is find out to be -119.5 kilojoule per mole. After cyclohexene, 1,3-cyclohexadiene was considered. Hexadiene means here is one double bond and here are two double bonds. Here heat which is released is -119. It means here energy that is released should be twice of -119.5, because it has two double bonds. So if del H, which is calculated by us is equal to 2 multiply minus 190, and this was minus 239 kilojoule per mole. But when observed, then del H value observed is minus 231.5 kilojoule per mole. Means observed value is less as compared to the calculated value, which shows that it is stable, and the stability is associated with this fact that conjugated dienes are somewhat more stable as compared to isolated double bonds. Means conjugated double bonds are that in which first double bond, then single bond, and then again comes double bond. These are called as conjugated. While if we write in this way, then it is not a conjugated diene, because both double bonds are separated by two single bonds. Okay. Third point is, now consider our hypothetical molecule 1,3,5 cyclohexatriene. Cyclohexatriene and its energy del H should be, as we are saying that here are two double bonds, so its energy should be twice. Here are tri means three double bonds, so its energy should be thrice to that of minus 119.5 kilojoule per mole. Means 3 multiply minus 119.5, and it should be equal to minus 358.5. But when observed, this was calculated. Observed was minus 208, and the results were surprising. Results were surprising because this value was very close to that which we calculated, but this value is not close to that which we calculated. The difference between these two values is 358 minus 208. The difference is 150.5 kilojoule per mole. It means that this less energy shows that benzene is more stable than hypothetical cyclohexatriene. Okay, because this value and this value, there are great difference between them, and the difference between them, this is called as resonance energy. So this difference, this is called as resonance energy. It means that benzene shows the phenomena of resonance, which makes it more stable. Now if we draw its diagram, then we would came to know, here is potential energy along y-axis. First of all, we are saying that cyclohexene and its energy is minus 190. Cyclohexene and its energy is minus 119.5. And after cyclohexene, we are saying 1,3 cyclohexadiene. And its energy is minus 231.5. Next is cyclohexatriene. In that we are saying this is a hypothetical molecule, and its energy is minus 358.5. But benzene energy was how much? It was minus 208, means minus 119, slightly more than minus 119, means here it will come here. Minus 208 kilojoule per mole, and this And the difference, that is 150.5, comes here. And this is called as resonance energy. So we can guess our results that benzene is somewhat more stable due to its resonance structures. Means resonance structures are here, you can see. These alternating double bonds, this may come here, means this one. So due to this resonance structure, it is more stable, and due to delocalization of electronic cloud also makes it more stable as compared to the hypothetical 135 cyclohexatriene molecule. Okay, thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.